Should you be logging each and every flight? Hey, Remote Pilot 101, Jason here. The answer is absolutely yes. And here's the thing, it's not required, but absolutely it's a wonderful idea to be logging your flights. We talked about this a few weeks ago about logging our maintenance. Well, you as the Remote Pilot Command should be logging your flights as well. There's going to come a day where the insurance company, when you go to get your drone insured, is going to ask, well, tell me about the Remote Pilot Command. How many hours does he or she actually have? And can you prove that? It doesn't have to be anything fancy. There's drone pilot logbooks out there you can buy, but you could just as easily make a nice Excel spreadsheet that you can have on the cloud, so it's there on the iPad, it's on the phone, and it's also on your computer, wherever you wish to keep it. It could be a notebook with pen and paper. We don't need to get fancy with this. Here's what I recommend logging. First and foremost, let's log the date that we flew, the location. I flew from this location, and you can get specific. I was at the city of Ocala Park, where whatever it is, you can write in the location of where it was. The aircraft that you flew, a Phantom 3 Pro, an Inspire 2, a Mavic 2 Pro, write in which one you flew. You could even give it the aircraft type, and you could even add a column for the registration number of that, because you may have multiple Mavics. Well, which one did I fly? This registration. The time in flight, how many minutes, hours, whatever it is, and all these apps track this for us so you can make it so much easier on yourself. I would then add two extra columns. I would have a column for remarks. What did I do? Why was I there? It was a real estate photo shoot. It was a tower inspection. It was work I was doing for FEMA. Whatever it is, I would log all of that in the remarks section. And then I have a column that says just Remote Pilot Command, or RPIC. And I would sign it with whomever that was, probably you, and just sign it, acknowledging that yes, this is correct, and I was Remote Pilot Command for this flight. It doesn't have to be fancy, but you should be logging your personal flight hours just as you should be logging your maintenance that you conduct as well. Well, do you log your flights? And if so, how do you do it? Maybe you want to share some screenshots with the RemotePilot101.com community. You can leave that in the comments below this video. We would love to see all of that and see what you all are up to. Listen, November 1st, I am doing a live on Facebook and on YouTube, really kind of a mock test going over and quizzing you on VFR sectional chart symbols and airspace. If you struggle with charts, if you struggle with airspace, November 1st at 7 p.m. on our Facebook page, on our YouTube page, you'll want to be there because that's where we're going over everything. I'll ask the symbol, I'll ask the airspace, let you type in your best answer. We'll work on why that's the right answer or why this is a better answer. And at the end, we're giving away some great Remote Pilot 101 gear as well as a Mavic 2 Pro. Links to sign up for all of that are in the video description underneath of this video as well. So I look forward to seeing you November 1st, 7 p.m. Remote Pilot 101 is the most successful Part 107 test prep course on the market with over 18,000 tests passed. It's one price and you get our updated initial and brand new recurrent course for life. It's two courses for the price of one, and it's for life. See the actual test questions, learn the material, take the practice quizzes, all at your own pace through our easy videos you've already grown to love. Visit RemotePilot101.com to become a member for life and learn more.